A Philippine embassy official says they are ready to evacuate Filipinos from Israel if the situation calls for it. Consul General and Deputy Chief of Mission Anthony Mandap says a repatriation is not necessary at this time. He adds so far there are no confirmed Filipino fatalities, but six nationals are still unaccounted for.
The situation remains tense, you know, and we have been closely monitoring the damage on the community by this conflict. And so far, we are tracking a number of Filipino citizens who have gone missing. And of course, the general mood here of the community is one of stress and discomfort. But we're trying our best to ensure that everyone is accounted for and safe. For the people who went missing, we are presuming that they could be in some kind of danger because they have been unreachable. For example, I think the five of the six we have been trying to contact for the past few days. By all means possible, we had their phone numbers with us. We were trying to contact them. I was trying to contact them individually, but all we get is, a response, the automated response. The phone is off or out of coverage. Mm-hmm. And some of them we tried to track on Facebook. I sent a personal Facebook message to one of them. There's been no activity. Mm-hmm. So that is really what worries us and the community right now.
Israel, however, is not interested in negotiating with Hamas militants who snatched and brought dozens of people over to Gaza. The spokesperson of Israel's Foreign Affairs Ministry says the country remains committed to securing all hostages regardless of their nationalities.
We are not negotiating with anyone at this time. We are in a war, and I think that this is not the time for negotiation and mediation. We are still trying to secure our border. We are not talking about negotiations nor mediations at this time.
The Israel Foreign Ministry also welcomes the decision of several European countries to review their financial aid packages for Palestine after the surprise attack of Hamas. A Filipino-Chinese business group sees the Israel-Hamas war negatively impacting the global economy. ABS-CBN correspondent Andy Taguines joins us on the line to tell us about the concerns raised by the Federation of Filipino-Chinese Chambers of Commerce and Industry over the conflict. Andy?
Denise, the Federation of Filipino-Chinese Chambers of Commerce and Industry Incorporated is worried business confidence could again take a hit because of the Israel-Hamas war, like what happened when the conflict began between Russia and Ukraine. FFCCCI President Cecilio Pedro also fearing the war would lead to a further increase in world oil prices, especially if other Middle Eastern countries get involved. But Pedro is still hopeful for a resolution. He also believes that despite the growing political tensions, the Philippines will remain attractive to international investors, largely due to its young workforce. Then again, he also stressed the need for the upskilling of Filipino workers, particularly in the use of new technologies such as artificial intelligence, to gain a competitive advantage against other markets.
The global economy is slowing down because of the war in Ukraine and Russia. And just a couple of days or 2 days ago, pumutok pa yung Israel and Palestinian war. That is going to hurt our world economy. Nawawala po yung confidence ng mga businessmen to go around to do business because of potential war. They say binomba nila yung Iran o yung Iraq, tatamaan yung oil. Di lalo tataas yung presyo natin sa oil. Pag tumaas ang presyo ng oil, patay. Lahat tayo, tataas ng presyo. Pati yung bigas, pati yung lahat. So that is a concern. Hopefully, they will settle as soon as possible.
Pedro, meanwhile, welcomed the Philippines' latest trade figures, which showed that the country's trade deficit had narrowed to $4.13 billion in August. But he said there is still room for exports to improve, adding that the Philippines should export more goods to China. Pedro added that he is off to China soon himself to encourage more Chinese businessmen to invest in the Philippines. Back to you, Denise.
Thanks, Andy.
The Department of Information and Communications Technology is asking for 300 million pesos in confidential funds as part of its cybersecurity measures. Secretary Ivan John Uy says the secret funds will be used in intelligence operations such as validating government data posted on the dark web. The secretary underscored the importance of having intelligence funds following the recent ransomware attack against PhilHealth. The agency is seeking the additional funds on top of the 600 million peso budget allotted to them this year.
Sa law enforcement po, at sa national security, kailangan po. Katulad nito, no? Yung sa hacking nito at sa mga ransomware dyan, mahirap po makakuha ng intel o ng data kung wala po tayong confidential fund na gamitin upang mahanap itong mga sources at matukoy kung to what extent itong mga data breach na ito po.
The secretary also says they are crafting a catch-up plan after it was cited as one of the agencies with a low budget utilization rate. Last year, the agency was given a 1 billion peso budget.